Good afternoon, everybody. So myself is C.S. Srinivas. I am working as Associate Professor in the Deputy Department from St. Martin's Engineering College. So today we will discuss DC generator. So what is a DC generator? So a machine which converts mechanical energy into electrical energy of DC nature is known as DC generator. So before going to DC generator, first of all, what is a machine? So any equipment which is having rotating parts, is known as electrical machine. So what is the principle of operation? So it works on the principle of electromagnetic induction principle, which states that the flux cut by conductor, and EMF will be induced in the generator. So that induced EMF direction is explained with the help of Fleming's right hand rule. So this is to stretch these three fingers, so perpendicular to each other. So thumb and forefinger, middle finger, stretch like this. So here thumb indicates the moment of the conductor, and forefinger indicates the flux direction, and middle finger indicates the induced EMF direction. So now we will explain the working principle. So for that we consider a 2-pole DC machine. So 2-pole DC machine, yes. So this is the north pole and south pole. We consider a simple 2-pole machine. So 2-pole machine, so north pole and south pole. Yeah. So now we consider a coil. So here A, B, D and C coil. So this rotating coil is known as armature. So this is nothing but the field flux. Okay, this is field winding. So now this coil is rotating in the field winding. Okay. So now the flux lines are flows from north pole to south pole. So now when the flux is produced in the generator, the flux also following the sinusoid. Okay, no, sinusoid. So for example, you take, so this is one position 1 and this is position 2 and 3, this is position 4 and 5. We will explain from this. Okay, no? So now at the time of starting, so the coil is parallel to the flux lines. So there is no cutting portion, so that an EMF induced is zero. So now that point is here. So this coil is parallel to the flux lines. There is no cutting portion, so that there is no induced EMF. So that point is here. Now slowly rotating the coil like this. So the cutting portion is slowly increasing. Now at this point, so the total the coil is perpendicular to the flux lines. So the cutting portion is maximum. So that point is this one. Again, slowly rotating like this. So rotating like this means slowly decreasing the cutting portion. Now at point 3, so it is parallel to the flux lines. The cutting portion is 0, so the induced EMF is also 0. Now again, reverse direction. Slowly goes on in the negative direction, the cutting portion will increase. At position 4, the cutting portion is maximum. So the EMF induced is also maximum, negative maximum. Now again, reverse. Means slowly goes on decreasing. At 0.5, so again parallel, there is no cutting portion, so that EMF induced is also 0. So now from this also, so what is the working principle? So it works on the electromagnetic induction. The flux lines are cut by the conductor, and EMF will be induced. That induced EMF is also an alternating nature or sinusoidal nature. So from this we can explain. Because this is the working principle of a DC generator. Yeah. Next very important derivation is EMF equation of a generator. Phi is the flux and is this speed of the armature? Speed of the armature in RPM. A is the armature parallel parts. A is the armature parallel parts. So next, the flux cut by one conductor. The flux cut by one conductor. The flux cut by one conductor is equal to number of poles into flux. Number of poles into flux. So this may be Weber's. Okay. And next, the flux cut by one conductor per 1 second. The flux cut by one conductor per 1 second is equal to P5 into N by 60. P5 into N by 60. So this is nothing but the flux cut by one conductor in 1 second is equal to, this is nothing but the EMF induced in 1 second. So EMF induced in 1 second is equal to, so P5 N by 60. So the EMF induced in 1 second per one conductor is equal to P5 N by 60. So therefore now total induced EMF is equal to the EMF generated for one conductor for 1 second is multiplied by, so total number of armature parallels. So this is equal to, so P5 Z by 60 into Z by N. P5 N, so this one is N. So P5 N by 16. So P5 N by 16 into Z by N. Where Z is the total number of armature conductors and N is the number of armature parallels. So this is equal to, so P5 Zn by 60 A. So this is nothing but the generated EMF EG. The generated EMF EG in case of generator. EG is equal to P5 Zn by 60 A volts. The units for generated EMF is equal to volts. Now, so we are in generator, we are having two types. So either it is generator or motor, we are having two types of windings. So first one is wave winding and lap winding. Now, so in case of wave winding, the armature parallel path A is always 2. In wave winding, the armature parallel path A is always is equal to 2. But in case of lap winding, the armature parallel path A is equal to P. So now substitute these values in the generated EMF equation. So the EG is equal to EG. If it is a wave winding, the generated EMF EG is equal to P5 Zn by 60 into A. In case of A, we substitute 2. This is equal to P5 Zn by 120 volts. So this is the generated EMF when the winding is wave winding. Now the winding is lap winding, the generated EMF EG is equal to P5 Zn by 60 A. So in case of lap winding, A equal to P. So substitute here P. So P gets cancelled. This is equal to 5 Zn by 60 volts. So this is the generated EMF. This is the generated EMF equation when we are connecting lap winding. This is the generated EMF equation when we are connecting a wave winding is wave winding. P5 Zn by 120 volts. So next topic is types of generators. So types of generators and classification of generators. Okay, so here are the types of generators. Mainly the generators are classified into two types. Okay, self-excited generators and separately excited generators. शंट जनरेटर, शंट जनरेटर, सीरीज जनरेटर,
thank you.